as you have done before.
My name is Michael. I'm 31 years old and I live in Lagos, Nigeria. My fiance's name is Angela. Angela and I applied for the K-1 visa. And if my interview is good, we'll be together in America very soon. Angela, she's a very strong woman. And she's real, very truthful, straightforward. In every relationship, there are definitely ups and downs, you know? But we love each other so much.
Let's go.
Let's have some fun. Since the last time Angela visited, I've just been by myself and I'm focusing on my visa interview, as well as visiting my family to spend time with them before I travel to America to be with her. Today, I'm at my uncle's house to play with the kids and see my uncle's wife. Where should I start from now?
I think from your... Yes.
Okay.
One, two, three. Good. Wow, I wonder if it's leading. So, Michael, how is Angela?
Yeah, she's fine.
And how long is it going to take before you can go there?
Yeah, once I go to the visa interview, once I'm approved, I'll book my ticket and fly over.
Wow.
Yes.
I pray it should happen very soon.
Yeah, I pray so too. I can't wait.
It's a little bit crazy, but Michael can choose for himself. So if that is what he wants, if it is okay by him, sure, it's okay by we too, the family. How many of you wish to follow your uncle to America?
Don't worry, I'll take you.
Auntie Angela?
Yes!
No problem.
I like it when Uncle Mike comes to visit. So I'll miss Uncle Mike when he comes to America.
So how are you feeling? Are you not nervous?
I'm a little bit nervous because I don't know what I'm going to expect. Before I go, I will definitely prepare very well.
Okay.
I'm not sure what life in the States will bring. To be honest, it's not going to be easy at the first stage because Angela lives in the southern Georgia, I mean, Hazelhurst, Georgia, so it's kind of a small town. And I can't work until my green card arrives. But I'm still excited to move to United States to be with my fiancé, you know, start a new chapter in my life and start a new family together. I love you all. Nice seeing you. Take care of yourself, yeah?
Yes!
Bye-bye.
Bye.
A couple of weeks ago, I met an American living here. He suggested I join him and his expat friends to learn more about what life is like in the States.
Look on the draw.
No, I've been abroad for like 15 years. Yeah, okay. So I've lived all over the world from Spain
Hello.
To
Michael.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Lindsay.
BB.
Marco. Okay, I'm Michael.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, moved to the States, lived there for about a decade, and then moved here to Lagos about 5 years ago now. I met Michael a few weeks ago, and he said that he was moving to America to be with his fiancé. So it's kind of cool to be able to advise Michael on what to expect. Where's Angela?
Yeah, she's in the States.
Oh, yeah?
Where in the States?
Here's yours, Georgia. It's like 4 hours to Atlanta.
Okay. Ooh, so that's like deep south.
When are you moving?
Oh, once my visa is approved.
Did you have your visa appointment?
Not yet.
Yeah, those are hard to get right now.
Ooh, yeah, yeah.
The American Embassy is a nightmare.
Yeah. Are you excited?
I feel so excited. I mean, I can't wait to be with my fiancé. And the distance relationship, it's not easy. It's hard,
sure.
No.
But how do you feel about moving to Georgia?
What I know is that Atlanta, you know, it's like a general place, just like Lagos here.
Mm-hmm.
Right. But where the part where my fiancé lives, and I think the town is a little bit small.
Has she told you about what the town is like? Is it very diverse? Are there other black people, Asian people?
Yeah. She said there are blacks and there are other races there. Black, white, Indians.
There's still, like, segregation in some places.
Especially in somewhere like Georgia.
Once I move there, I'll mind my business. If I'm gonna go anywhere, I'll go with my fiancé, my woman.
I'm born and raised in California, and being Black in America is serious. Like, it's not a small thing, you know, especially in a rural area. I lived in a small town before in the middle of nowhere, and there's still a lot of racism there. We can be helpful, but I worry about him a little bit. Like, have you thought about, you know, what you're gonna do for work?
The immigration process, it's, yeah, stages. So it's gonna take a while to get a job. At least, because I don't like depending on women.
Of course. Yeah. No, as a Nigerian man.
Yeah. I mean, my woman, she's a very hardworking woman.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
Despite her age, she's very agile.
How old is she?
Yeah, she's 53.
53?
How old are you?
I'm 31.
Okay.
Ooh. Okay, so there's a 20-year age difference?
So she's 53. You don't want children then? Because she can't have children.
Of course, I want children.
You do.
So yes. How do you plan on?
But you
will you adopt?
You're marrying an older woman.
No. Probably via IVF.
Do you know how expensive that is?
Yeah. I know. We've talked about this.
Also, I mean, her health. Yeah. Like, she has to be able to actually carry the baby.
Yeah.
At that age.
I'm persuading one of our daughter to like give us an egg.
Oh wow.
It's important for me to have my own child and my own DNA to carry on my name. To be honest, Angela doesn't want more kids. God, Angela understands the importance of a child to me.
So you're moving to Georgia, and
yeah,
you also want to convince one of her children to carry your child.
That's... No, to give an egg.
With the IVF. Don't you think this is a little bit too much?
No, it's not. It's not going to be immediately like that. At least I have to settle down, you know, have a job. Income, you know, to support the family, but I'm definitely sure it's gonna happen because she knows how important a child is to me.
It's crazy what you're getting yourself into. I think people have a lot of ideas about what moving to America is about, but reality will definitely come in. I mean, I hope him the best, but it seems like the most outrageous thing that he could possibly do.
I think he's in for a very, very rude awakening. Reality's gonna hit him. It's gonna hit him quick and fast. And hard.